down before you, bringing all that I am, longing only to know you, seeking your face, and not holding your hand, I find you embracing me, just as I
oh. seated. We as a family have been praying with and for Lainey. Sadie said, I think we need to ignore her this morning. And I think that's something we need to do. So I'm just going to ask, as some of these prayer warriors are coming up to lay hands on her and pray, I'd like you to just raise your hands for her. Just pray for her. Just lift her before the Father right now. And all God's people said.
Amen.
All God's people said.
Amen.
So let it be done. So let it be done. Yesterday, Sandy and I were out for a little while checking out the garage sales. We stopped to talk to see this particular garage sale. This guy had a classic Mustang. It was sweet. It was 1980. It's pretty. So we just talking, and you know, one thing leads to another. And God always opens opportunities for us to talk, and. They were attending a conservative church, very much like ones I had been affiliated with in the past. And we were talking about certain things, and you know, they like, why did you leave where you were? And I said, because God revealed things I'd never seen before. The power of the Holy Spirit. I said, man, I didn't even know the Holy Spirit existed. Like, I know today that he exists. And I said, one of the things that we say at Freedom all the time is that it's not about the how, it's about the why. Yeah. that is the core of our belief system here. And he said, wow, man, he goes, you know, I guess I consider myself kind of out of the box too. And I thought, I can't even find a box anymore. So, you know, I think Sandy burned it last year at the burn pile. I think that box got burned. But he said that, I said, and I told him, we're about to find out the how, and he said, oh, I know what you mean. He said, our church, you can't serve. He said, I told him, because y'all take communion? I said, every week. He said, I just found out last week, I can't. You can't serve communion here if you're not wearing a coat and tie. Hey, don't laugh, I've been there. Some of you have been there too. Amen. You know, and he said, a guy come up and said, hey, if you got a coat and tie in your car, we need somebody to serve communion. He goes, well, no, I don't have a coat and tie, but I'll be glad to serve. They said, oh, no, we can't let you. He said, how do y'all do it? I said, we do it like the Catholics. And he just laughed. I said, not really. We just, up front, you come, whoever. Because we know that it's about the blood of Jesus Christ. We know that it's about the broken body of Jesus Christ. We know that it was a free gift of grace given to us. Nothing that we earned, nothing that we deserved. The Lord's Supper was an institution given to us that we might remember. And in that remembrance, we might say, we love you, Father. Thank you. To never forget what Jesus did on that cross. That his body was broken and his blood was shed. It wasn't yours and mine. That's the why we do it. It is never about the how. When I think of the first days Freedom, we got established. One of the very first Sundays that we took communion, I left the emblems at the house. You remember this?
Yes.
And we took them with Dixie cups.
And white bread.
And white bread. Yeah, we did. We had loaf bread and Dixie cups.
Fruit juice or something.
Yeah, yeah. It wasn't even good Welch's drink. It was, you know.
Fruit punch and Dixie cups.
That's what, you know. But I believe that it didn't matter. I believe that it's the why. When your heart has the why, your mind has the knowledge that you need. It is about glorifying Jesus. It's his institution. It's not ours anyway. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you so very much that we're able to partake this morning. We know, Father, it's not about the cup. It's not about the juice. It's not about the bread. It is about the victory that was won at the cross. It was about the security and delivering our salvation to you. Our sins. We found pardon at the cross, and we found freedom at the empty tomb. For that, we will always be grateful. For that, we say hallelujah. For that, we say hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Bless us as we partake this morning in Jesus' most precious name. Amen. And amen. If you're visiting with us, you're welcome. You don't have to be a part of the club. You just have to be a part of Christ. Amen. Let's partake this morning.
Stand in your presence.
I like tacos, but you know, I almost put on a sombrero. I'm not trying to be offensive. So that's coming up. Wednesday night Bible study. We are talking about miracles. And the lesson stuff is coming from a book called The Grave Robber. And so we're having a lot of fun with that, being blessed. And young people, if everybody come, be a part of that. That's Wednesday night. Thursday morning, Bible study with Brother Selby, who has probably the funniest hat on in this entire place. it's funny to look at, but go read it. It's even, I told him I should be wearing that hat this morning. it's like herding cats sometimes. So at Thursday night, prayer and meditation. Let me say this about that. I think it's just, it's a wonderful time to experience this. But I'm going to say that if you're kind of in the middle of the week, if you're just really flustered, if you're feeling like, and you say to yourself, I just need to sit down and be quiet. Let me tell you, come here and sit down and be quiet and watch God do something. I mean, I know last week I really needed to be in prayer and meditation last week, and God just ministered to me in such a tremendous way. And so let me encourage you to come on Thursday night and be a part of that. I skipped something. Let me back up. Thursday is National Day of Prayer. And if you're not doing anything at 12 o'clock, we will, I need to talk to you. Yeah, I know. Oh, by the way, Joe. 12 o'clock, we will be at Spruma Park City Hall. We've done this for the last, I don't know how many years, 7 or 8 years. But we will be leading another congregation. Their ministers are actually promoting this week. And so we'll be meeting at City Hall, in City Hall, with the air conditioning this year. Yeah, I'm telling you, we're stepping up town. Yeah. But we will be praying for our nation, our city, our state, a lot of stuff going on, but it is National Day of Prayer. Let me encourage you to come out. If you're not busy, if you have time at lunch or whatever, 12 o'clock Thursday to pray. And you get a real treat because Kathy Lamb usually brings little kids up. And so they're a hoot. Yes?
I just wanted to say, if you haven't been, Lou loaded the Easter pictures from Easter service on our website. You're just so good. I love your equestrian pictures too, but you know, when you're doing our church stuff, I just it blesses my heart. But he's downloaded those on our website. You should go and look at the photos that he keeps on there. And I told Raina, there's really just an awesome one. And also, Nancy Henry needs to go look. There's one of Fiona that Barry and I just fell in love with. But there's just all of us doing the cross with the flowers, and they're just, it's beautiful. Beautiful work. Thank you.
Thank you. And then some of this weird stuff will be on there too.
Here's the website I'm going to lay it out there. It's www.freedom-community.church.org.
Give me the last slide there. See if we got it right.
There it is.
You were right.
It
I was
dash.
Wrong.
It is dash.
Yes. I thought I put it in
there. There you go.
Yes, and the truth be told. The truth be told, it's not about Freedom Community Church. It really is about the dash. It's about
it's
all the happens in between. It is about the dash. I'm telling you right now. Okay. Any more announcements? Yes.
I have to tell you about a lady, a phenomenal lady, that works for Operation Shoebox for me. She works in our community. She doesn't go to Shoebox every Monday and work with everybody else. She and a group of about 8 women that I've organized in our neighborhood work at home. And every Monday I take their stuff in and give it to Shoebox. She makes bags and she makes Christmas stockings for the troops. She She has been working with Operation Shoebox between 5 and 6 years. This last week, she sold and turned in her 13,000 Christmas stockings.
Wow.
Now this is the phenomenal thing. She's not a born American, she's an American by choice. She came here from England, and I went over to see her yesterday because I was doing garage sales, and she happened to have a small garage sale out, and I recognized the address and I stopped, but I had already written her a letter thanking her and everything. Shoebox gave her a standing ovation at their meeting Monday. She wasn't there to hear it because she doesn't go. She wasn't there to see it, but everybody else knew. And when I said to her, "Betty, you make me proud to know you. I am so proud to know you." And she said, "I am so thankful to this country and to its soldiers. I love my soldiers." And I thought to myself, everybody says to me, "Oh, you do such a good job, and you know, you take the praise for everybody else that works for Shoebox." I take the praise. She made me feel that big. This is a lady that really loves the country. I mean, my God, put out 13,000 Christmas stockings in less than 6 years.
Amen.
So think about what you do for your country. Think about how much you love your country and what you do for it. Okay? Thank you.
Okay, real quickly.
Changing hats?
Yeah. Wednesday's taco night. If I offended you, get over it. Okay, I got one very special announcement, so I need your close attention to this. Nothing on my sleeve. Come here. Lou, you got this on?
It should be.
Test.
No. Wait.
Maybe I don't know. Test.
Well, you got, it's picking up your...
Right now? Here it is.
Let's
Jason speak
to it.
Here, I'm picking me up.
Oh, wow. Hello. This thing on? Hello.
Is there a switch there, Joe?
No, turn the fader on the top. The trim's already turned off, probably.
That's what it is.
There you go.
Try it now.
Testing.
There you go.
Testing.
Yeah, like I ever needed a microphone, right, ladies and gentlemen?
Humor me.
I'm good. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Let me spend a little bit of time with you. I have something very special I want to say to this special young lady over here. You guys might want to sit down for this. I've been thinking about this now since, we met in January on the 1st. So you might want to get ready for this. I've been wanting to say this to you since I met you. And everybody who knows me has known that I've been kind of different. Since I joined this wonderful organization of friends and family, I finally got a new member of my family, hopefully, if she'll take me. Jenny Larney, in front of your daughter and my new family, will you marry me?
In more ways. situation, you know it, brother. Father God, I just rejoice at this occasion. Lives coming together. I have such a fond affection for this young man. I've seen such a transformation in his life. A thing only you could do, Father. But he comes with an open heart, an open spirit, and for that I am truly grateful. I'm thankful that you have brought to him a woman of faith, someone who loves you as much as he is learning to love you, and the one who comes brings a daughter. We celebrate this family. And I ask, Father, on behalf of Pastor Sandy and myself, a special blessing on this engagement, a special blessing on the upcoming marriage, and a blessing the rest of their lives. They will seek to do your will and enjoy doing it. Bless them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Somebody say hallelujah.
Only it for you.
I didn't know any other way to do it except to do my family.
Yeah. Well, that's a first. Amen. 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 Wow. I can't think of a better place to do it. Amen. It's the wine.
Hey,
come,
guys.
You want to come here? Come here.
Uh-oh.
More?
Yeah, we're not done.
As of this morning, I'm officially a West Point candidate.
Mountains bow down, every open door.
Yes.
Pastor inspired me, so I'm gonna
throw this out there. A lot of you don't know this, but Diane and I have been going through some financial struggles. And I think it's time for me to just step up to the bar, lay it down, and say, you know what? You got this.
Amen.
Got this.
Amen. Amen.
You got this.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. God is good, and He will take care of it.
Amen.
You got this.
God's got that. Amen and amen. Somebody did actually question why I did the hat thing, and I was serious about. I just wanted to do it for fun. I mean, I was serious about that, but I also had another motive for doing it. And this is it. You're guinea pigs. You just didn't know it. What I was curious about is this. If we could do something a little weird, how well would you participate? If we could do something a little so off the wall, how you would handle it? And could we step outside ourselves to do it? Well, I think more than anything, you have stepped way out of yourself. Amen? 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 And that's a good thing, because God can use us when we step out of our way. When we get out of the way, God can use us. I thank you for participating. I thank you for just enjoying it. We'll do this in the future. I don't know what we're going to do next. You know, we may have dress day and see what happens there. No, we're kidding. Thank you so much for your spirit. And the ladies always stepped up. I knew they would. You've got some of the most clever stuff. Cindy Taylor flew in from the Kentucky Derby yesterday to be with us. I'm just kidding. But that's, and more of that. Oh, man! That is too cool. That is too cool. Yesterday, Sandy and I always watched Kentucky Derby. We were watching it going, I was wondering if anybody would show up with a Kentucky Derby hat.
It really is.
It is. All right. Let's close in prayer. Father God, thank you so much for this day. Thank you for the joy and just the love that is in this place. I thank you that we are reminded daily of how awesome you are. And no matter what we're struggling through, we're going to declare, you got this. And so we praise your name. Bless us as we leave this place. Bring us back together safely. Be with those that are traveling. Traveling mercies on top of them as they travel. Put your angels in charge, Father. I thank you for this day. I thank you for tomorrow and what you're going to do. Bless us. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. And amen. God bless. Have a great day.